Yo!
Video games.
Yo dudes, Matt here from Yo Video Games, and now that the dust around E3 has finally settled, I thought I'd share with you some of my impressions regarding the new Super Smash Bros. For 3DS and for Wii U. Upon arriving at E3, I was given a VIP tour by Nintendo to go check out both of the games hands-on right away. The very first thing I noticed about the game is that the game does a really big job of confirming hits. In other words, when you hit someone with a really strong smash attack, the game has almost a longer, more prominent freeze before a person gets knocked out of the arena. But that's all kind of fluff. The things I think people really want to know is, how is the speed and flow of the game? Well, the speed is definitely faster than Brawl. It's not as fast as Melee. It's like this middle ground between the two. But something that's more important than the speed of the characters, because if you just run around, jump and drop and all that, you'll notice the speed's, yeah, it's much faster. But what you might realize after you start actually getting into fights is that attack moves have a lot of animation to them. And what this does is, this means that doing a particular move, whether it be a normal A attack or a smash attack or a special attack with B, is that there's tons and tons of recovery on it. I don't know if this was a design choice or if it's just a byproduct of the animation being so fluid and so many different frames of animation in each character and all their movements, but it basically is affecting the gameplay of it. Now, what this means is certain characters like Rosalina, who I played a lot as, she has the ability to send out a Luma, which kind of makes her really good in this build of the game, whereas she can actually attack with a secondary creature that she's puppeting. For people who don't know what's really going on in the game yet, this makes it really easy to win victories off of her. One of the other things about the game is that it was time only, 2 minutes, no stock, so naturally this sort of game mode encourages very defensive play. Like, it encourages people to stand back, wait for other people to rack up their percentages, and then come in and then finish them off, basically assassinate people. More than just the mode, the feel of the game and the time it takes to recover from any given attack means that you're going to be playing the game very, very defensively. This is a game that's all about, in a weird sort of word, like camping, like waiting and waiting and dodging and just waiting for the opportune moment to use an attack, because you know if you miss, then you're probably going to be able to be counterattacked easily, or you're going to leave yourself open to the third or fourth player you're fighting against. This makes it really different and from other Smash Brothers in a weird sort of sense. Now, we weren't able to try one-on-one at all. When it's one-on-one, if you're doing attacks and missing and you're having all this recovery and then someone else is having the same issue with you, it could make battles kind of slow. I almost fear that this game is almost devolving into a sort of Street Fighter 4 aspect of Smash Brothers, where moves are very, very, very calculated. It's a very, very defensive game. And I feel that's kind of opposite of what Smash Brothers should be going for. Some other feelings about the game is, it did feel like a very strangely early build of the game we were playing. The user interface was clearly not done. We had a really, really small sampling of stages. The roster was very small. Like, we only got like a chunk of the announced characters so far. So everything felt like maybe this was just a really old build, and maybe things are just not finalized yet. And that's a good hope, but I almost don't think that's the case. And the reason I don't think that's the case is because after attending the Smash Brothers roundtable with game director Masahiro Sakurai, I get the feeling that he basically is a very stubborn and very self-sure person. If you go back and look at some of his reactions to interviews and user complaints regarding Kid Icarus Uprising, you'll see that he's very, very set in his ways. He doesn't believe anything he's ever created or done has been wrong. He doesn't believe there are any control like problems in Kid Icarus and that you just needed to get used to it. Some of his reactions to some of the questions and answers sort of seem to back this up. Someone asked him, hey, if I could beat you in a one-on-one for glory mode, could I help you balance the game? And his response was, have you ever designed a game before? The impression I get off of him is that he's very stubborn and he's very egotistical. And he has no reason to think otherwise. His games are enormous successes. He has made the best-selling fighting game of all time. There is no reason for him to believe otherwise, that anything he's done is wrong. And to be honest, and this is something no one's going to want to hear, he's almost right to a point, because the vast, vast majority of people who buy Smash Brothers games have no idea of the intricacies of battle or recovery animations or anything of that nature. So, reality is, it's not going to impact the sales of the game, whether or not he fixes sort of the problem that the game is an intensively defensive-focused title. And that's just going to kind of be the way it is. I mean, if you really want to play competitive Smash, you're going to have to stick to Melee or Project M most likely, because I do not believe that this game is going to be tailored towards competitive play at all. And even more to back this up is Sakurai referred to the game as a party game at the round table when questioned about sort of balancing and the competitiveness of it. He was saying how, you know, some characters naturally are going to be balanced for four-player and some will be balanced for one-on-one, but he said he wanted to make sure that the spirit remained a party game. However, I think there's something he's completely missing here, and it's never going to probably get through to this guy, and that is, if he made the game competitive, it would not affect the game sales either. In other words, people who are going to buy this game and not know any of the intricacies wouldn't know it if there were intricacies. In other words, he could make the game competitive, he could make the game really balanced, and people would still buy it, because the game being unbalanced and the game being super defensive heavy and the game having way too many recovery animations, casual gamers will not notice that, and they wouldn't notice it if it was fixed either. So it's going to sell regardless. So there's really not a good reason not to make the game more competitive, not to speed up the flow of animations and all that. However, in his mind, what he's doing is right, and I don't think there's anyone who can convince him otherwise. The simple fact of the matter is he balanced Melee all on his own, according to him. He had 4 people focus test and balance the game with him on Brawl, and he said he's upped that to 12 on Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and 3DS. And 12 people balancing a fighting game, if anyone has developed a fighting game or been involved heavily in the development of a fighting game would know that that is unbelievably fucking stupid. That is the dumbest fucking thing you can do. And he even talked about how if too many people are balancing a game, like, or if anyone's balancing a game, they can get biases on what they want a character to be like, how good they want certain characters to be. Yet he follows that up by saying, I'm only having 12 people balance this game. It's like he doesn't realize what he's saying is true. Like, you're gonna, if you yourself and only a small handful of people are balancing the game, and those people have similar tastes, they're gonna beef up certain characters and they're gonna ignore other characters. And he's right about that, but he's not realizing that that's exactly what's gonna be happening to his game. So, and again, I just don't think he sees this as a problem. So, unfortunately, I think the game will never be competitive at this stage if it continues down this path. There were a lot of people from Treehouse and Nintendo taking notes and taking feedback. Me and Max all gave feedback to multiple people, and I really hope something gets through because it really could need it as far as competitive scene goes. I'm still going to play it. I'm still going to like the game, but it's basically going to turn similar to what Brawl is, and then I play it for fun. I don't play it for competitiveness or to raise a skill set or anything. I know that's probably not anything some of you want to hear. I know it's not something Max wants to even consider. You can either accept how it is going to be and just enjoy it for what it is, or you can basically just not play it and go back to Project M and go back to Melee, because that's kind of going to be where I think it's going to go as far as competitiveness goes. If you can't stand a game that's not very competitive, it does not reward like people learning a moveset or a skill set or a mind game of opponent versus this opponent, then if you can't enjoy a game without that, then you probably shouldn't be too excited for this title. But from what we're seeing right now, it feels early, and it scares me because the game is coming out this year. The 3DS version was even less polished, less ready to go, and that's coming out first, and that's kind of really scary. I mean, to be honest, Mortal Kombat 10, from what I played of that game feels more polished and more balanced and tuned, and that's coming out next year, and that's coming out with a much, you know, longer, harder development cycle, because that's going to be on a PS4, Xbox One. The graphics have to be so much better, and everything has to be so much better for those games, and yet they're more polished in this state now than Smash Brothers is, and Smash Brothers is coming out earlier, so a little concerning. But if you don't care about anything I've said regarding competitiveness, regarding how strategic, you know, a game needs to be, or how fast and fluid animation needs to work, if you don't care about any of that and you just want to have fun, Smash Brothers will deliver that for you. But if you're looking for the next Melee or next Project M, you're going to want to stick to Project M. Or, more importantly, you're probably going to want to just wait for Project M to come on to this game, because the Wii U is going to get hacked to hell. It's happened already a bit, and it's going to happen more in the future. You might just want to wait till someone mods this game, because as it is, if it stays this way, and I have a pretty good feeling it's going to stay this way mostly, then yeah, just wait for Project U, as I would call it now. Those are my impressions of the game. I'll be giving more impressions of other games. I got an exclusive Xenoblade Chronicles X interview coming up, and hope to see you guys and hear all your comments on the channel. Later, dudes.